I'm Jonathan Ayres with Network for Success, and today we're going to talk about what you need to hook up a wireless router. Well, the first thing we've got to do is go out and buy a wireless router, or if you have one in your house and you want to hook it up, let's see how that's done. Right in front of me, I have the most common wireless router known as a Linksys. That's the brand. You see it has two antennas on the top. And in the front, we just have a panel with a row of lights, nothing to push, no buttons anywhere or anything. So in order to hook up a wireless router, we're going to turn around and look at the backside. On the backside, we see we have a number of different places to plug things into. So the first thing we notice is that on the far right-hand side, there's a place to plug in a power supply. You have to provide power before the wireless router will work. So we're going to take our power supply, plug it in the back, and then plug this into the wall, and then that will turn the wireless router on. Now, once it's on, is it going to operate? Not by itself, by any long shot. It's going to have data to transmit over the airwaves wirelessly so that computers can pick that information up or share that information. So we're going to have to provide this wireless router with incoming information. So that means you need to have a supplier, and let's take the internet as an example. If we want to transmit the internet wirelessly inside our house so that all of our users can have access to the internet, first we need a cable with the internet, and we're going to get that from Time Warner Cable or AT&T or Comcast or somebody. They're going to bring a cable into our house, and we're going to have a cable to plug into the back of the wireless router. Each router is different, but you will have a place to plug this internet cable into, and we'll plug this in here. Now, the very next thing you're going to do is you're going to have to configure this router, and configure it means to tell it who you are, where you're located, and how to get to you to transmit that information that it's going to send out over the airwaves. And the way that you do this is you configure all of these routers through a browser. So you use Internet Explorer or Safari or Firefox or Opera or one of the browsers, and you'll take the manufacturer's instructions, which will tell you an address to go to. You type that into your browser, and then that will allow you to set up your wireless router. So what do we need in order to get our wireless routers operating properly? We need a power supply, we need a cable, and we need a setup program, and then we're ready to go.